Ubiquiti seems to have a need for speed these days, and just as I was getting used to the 2.5 gig speeds on the Pro HD 24 PoE, they send me this beast.
I feel the need for speed.
This is the Pro XG 10 PoE, which was soft launched and teased when they launched the XG and XGS access points. That video dropped about a month ago and also had a hero image of the full lineup of the XG switches. The product pages went live on the site, but you could not get them until now. Ubiquiti was kind enough to send over the Pro UXG 10 PoE, but there's also a 24 and 48 port option. There's also an 8-port desktop class XG 8-port PoE that costs $499, but is not available yet. Lastly in the image was also a Pro XG aggregation, but that has not been released or even a price set yet, as I understand it. The Pro XG lineup is designed to give PoE plus through all of its Ethernet ports, as well as Etherlighting, of course. And in this case has two 10 gig SFP ports on the 10 port, two 25 gig on the 24, and a whopping four 25 gig SFP ports on the 48 port. The three models differ on how much speed and power you're going to get out of the PoE ports. In the case of the XG10, you get a shared 400 watts PoE plus out of all individual ports that are 10 gigabit as well. The XG24 has 8 2.5 gig ports and 16 10 gig ports, all sharing up to 720 watt PoE supply. The 48 comes in, of course, with the most ports at 16 2.5 gig ports and 32 10 gig ports, all sharing a whopping 1,080 watts of PoE power. As you can see, I have with me and have been testing the Pro XG10 and think it is an incredible value for the money. This is an excellent device if you're looking to power exclusively a 10 gig network. Compared to the Pro HD 24 behind me, it does have less total wattage, but also that's not fair because you're going down from 24 ports to 10. Now, because I always get asked this question, I did do a sound test to see how loud the fans were on this device, because when you do boot it up, the first time you can hear those fans start running, it gets pretty loud. However, when things calmed down, it was done doing the updates and it was just serving network over a handful of ports, it was resting at a comfortable 44 decibels. I did try cranking up the fans to 100% to see how loud it would get, and it did go all the way up to 60 decibels. Like I said, they're pretty loud. That being said, unless you live in a very warm climate and aren't cooling your network racks, you're not going to hear it be all that loud. It's going to be similar to what normally comes out of the other switches as well. Let's get it racked up, head over to the computer, and take a look. That's it, now we boot. All right, we've got the USW Pro XG10 PoE plugged in and updated, and as you can see, I plugged a couple of things in as well. Let's take a quick look. This is gonna be familiar to anybody who's ever seen this before. You've got your IP address, MAC address, etc., all this information over here. And so far, so good. You've got some insights, brand new, relatively, so it's not going to have a whole lot of information here. Statistics, usual stuff that you'll find here. You have, of course, your Etherlighting setup, colors, etc., your general settings, your display rotation, nighttime mode, how bright you want it to be, and so on and so forth. Welcome what I am calling Studio B. Studio A, my usual setup, is currently under construction, hence the delay in getting this video out, as well as a change in scenery in my next couple of videos, or next several videos, depending on how long this takes. I do have a whole video on the construction and the redesign and how all that is coming out soon, but let's get back to the video. I now have my U7 XGS Pro hooked up to the switch, as well as USW Flex 2.5 being powered by USB++, and the XGS, of course, has the 10 gig throughput. Let's take a look at that on the desktop and see what that looks like. Okay, no camera in this section because, well, I haven't set one up yet, and my background is not a background, it looks like crap. So, let's jump right into it here. I've got the, as I mentioned before, the U7 Pro XGS plugged in, as well as the USW Flex 2.58 PoE, and we are seeing here in the port manager, if you look over here, we've got 10 gigabit speed across the board, which is just beautiful. I love it. We've got the U7 Outdoor coming on here. What is this? That's being mislabeled for some reason, but okay, that probably just because I recently plugged it in and it's trying to figure itself out. But as you can see here, you've got the two of those plugged in and it is rocking and rolling at 10 gig speed. And then you've got the fiber out, the SFP out to the Pro HD 24. You can also see that you've got full PoE plus power coming off of the switch to both of these. And as these are lower power devices, we're not using a whole lot of power here, so we're not even getting close to maxing out the capabilities of this switch. But it's got a lot of power to go around, and that'll be really useful and come in really handy in various different environments. Now to go start working on the new WAN switch review. One thing to note that they showed off this morning is that there is also an 8-port desktop class XG PoE switch that is coming soon. It'll be $499 and is expected to launch in May of this year. Additionally, there is a Pro XG aggregation switch that has been announced and shown off. It'll cost $24.99 and is coming soon. The Pro XG 10 PoE costs $699, the 24 costs $17.99, and the 48 costs $24.99. All three are available today.